Welcome to the edition of Let's Play Farming Simulator 2013 on the Bayern Farm. Alright, as promised, I did only one load last episode, and we're going to sell the rest of our pigs, I almost said cows, now. So we're going to go ahead and set this guy up, so he is going to unload our pigs. So, we're not sure how much money we're going to get in the end, but we made quite a bit of money last day from the load of pigs that we sold. So we're going to let him do his thing. And we'll see how far we get with that, because I think we're actually going to get pretty far, actually. We'll probably should get in the 100 and, well, probably the 200 range based on the first time we did it. So we'll see what happens in that regards. So we'll just unload all of our pigs, because we have enough liquid manure for the time being to keep us moving forward for a little bit yet. So we'll see how that goes. Also, if you recall from the last episode, our canola is ready, and I got my combine. He's currently... Wow, that seems like an awful lot of canola. Why is that so much canola after one pass? Weird. That is rather odd, because I don't think that would be the case. Maybe it is. I don't know. Have to keep an eye on that, because maybe it's some sort of... I hope it's on another conflict or something, because that would be rather annoying in that situation, so we'll have to see how that, or what happens there, because one pass for that much canola? I don't know. I hope that's not something. Like I said last time, I did install a few mods, so hopefully it's not due to the mods or anything like that, but we'll see. We'll see how much canola we actually get from this, but just that one strip seems like it's a bit much. Makes me a bit nervous. Hopefully it's nothing too crazy. What do we got over here? We have our... Well, it's not over here. Where is it? A little bit further down here, we got our hay field. And I think it's ready to be harvested as well. Want to make sure we stay on top of hay harvesting, because we don't want to get... don't want to fall behind, basically. Oh yeah, we're ready to go. Cool. So let's get our harvester. Let's get our chopper, Moko, which I think is over in the corner here somewhere. So we'll go ahead and get that done. And that'll keep us moving forward in terms of how much grass we have. How much do we have left, actually? We have 44,000 liters of grass. Well, it's not terrible, but I want to try and stay ahead of that, because that's basically only one load, and basically once our mixing station runs out of grass, we basically need to take one load down there and fill it up, which is 47,000 liters, so basically that would be gone in a jiff, pretty much. That's what it boiled down to. Grass mow, first point, perfect. Where is that? Oh, it is over there. I always forget where the first point for mowing is versus rake. Because the rake starts on the other side, and this one starts right here. I don't know. Alright, how's he doing? He's taking a load there. So let's just tag along for a second to see how much money we actually get from this. Because last time we got like almost... How much was it? $50,000? I can't be right, but... Something in that area. So we'll see how much we get from this. So this is 93,000. We have 93 right now. Jeez, that didn't take much. $93,000, and we'll see how much this load of pigs gets us. I'm guessing maybe in the $140,000 range. That's my guess, at least, so we'll see what happens. Is it going to be 140? There's 100. 110. Ooh, 120. 130. 140. Wow, 143. Almost got $150,000. Yeah, we're definitely gonna crack. We got at least two loads left of pigs, so that'll give us... how much money is that? Yeah, it's about 50,000 per load, or just about. Yeah, just about, actually. I think it's actually a bit more. 53, maybe? Or 52 and a half, or 50, something like that. That's nuts. Jeez. Alright, it is a bit cloudy out here today, so I hope we don't have... I don't think we're expecting rain. No, not today. So that'll be good. We'll be able to get all the work done on the farm today, which is what we want to do, of course. We don't want to not be able to get work done on the farm. The only thing I wish this particular mod was able to do is work with questplay in terms of turning off and turning back on, but I don't know why. You can just turn it on, you have to leave it on, basically, which is a bit sad because it's a pretty cool mod otherwise, but it's a minor quibble, but yeah, you know. It's one of those things that you just don't realize, and the more you use the mod, the more you'll realize how it works and whatnot, so I don't know. Let's see how our combine's doing. Yeah, there's something wrong. That's a lot of canola. What? I wonder what it could be, because that's like... that's weird. It must be from a mod or something, because that's a crazy amount of canola just from that. I don't think so. That's already like 20,000 liters, basically, almost. Erg. I wonder what that could be. Oops. Nope. I want this one. Oh, it was the right one. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see. That seems like it's a bit much. I don't know what it is. I don't have the moralistic mod install or anything like that. But this seems like it's getting a lot of canola from that, so. It must be one of the maps I downloaded or something, and that's giving me a weird issue with this. That's the only thing I can think of, is it's a weird issue with some mods conflicting or something like that. Kind of like what happened on the Serbian farm, and I think I have some mods accidentally installed from that or something, so. I'll have to take care of that. For now, I'm not that worried about it. It happened, whatever. Can't do much about it at this point, so. Yeah, that's a lot. That is a lot. I'll have to go through and fiddle with the mods again, see what's what. I thought I took a whole bunch of them out, but I guess I didn't, sir. Because it should not be getting this much all at once. Let me know if you agree or not, because that seems like an awful lot just from, what, three passes, basically? Yeah, this seems something like... yeah, I think I have to go through the mods and take something out. And I hope it doesn't happen with this, too. Because that would be slightly annoying, but wouldn't be the first time something like that happened. Alright, he's going for the next load. Excellent. And we're going to be down to just... how many pigs are going to be down to? 130 or so pigs, somewhere in that area. And we'll see how that puts... or see where that puts us, because that... next load of pigs should put us up in the range of getting a field. So, for example, if we look at field 39, actually, field 28 is currently on auction. We actually could get that. Where is field 28? Let's take a quick walk over there and see where it is. I think it's actually pretty close to us. Well, based on the way the map looks, it looks awfully close. Yeah, it's over here. Where is it? I think it's this one in the back over here. Yeah, that's which one it is. Let's just go take a quick peek. Because the way it works with the Bank of Hagenstein is it shows you the maximum price based on the auctions, I think, but not the price you can get at auction. I think that's how it kind of works. The maximum auction price is what you see rather than something else. Alright, where is it here? This field right here. It's kind of out of the way. Where's my... maybe it's on the other side. Because usually in the middle of the field, but I think this map has them on the side somewhere. And I just need to find out where it is. Maybe it's somewhere in town. I think that's what it is. Yeah, because there's a real estate place in town. I had forgotten about that. Well, we're halfway in town already. Let's just walk to town, I guess. Yeah, I think it's like a real estate place I think you have to go to in order to buy property on the map. And I totally forget where it is. So I'll have to go take a quick peek and see where it is. So here's the handler place. Let's continue on. It's somewhere back in here. Is it further in town? I can't remember. I think I only went there like once, but I think it has like a sign out front saying, "Hey, this is a place you should be aware of," or something like that. No, that's not it. That's a shed. That's a gas tank. Where is it? Landhandel. Well, maybe that's this way. Landhandel. That seems like oh no, that's no, that's not right. Can I walk in here? No. I know you can do it on this map. I know there's a way to do it. But maybe it is this place here. But I totally forget where it is. Which is not very helpful at all. Land handle. That's the water. That is not what I'm looking for. I can't open this door or anything, can I? No. Oh, here we are. Land hell. That's not what I was looking for then either. Huh, I don't know where it is then. Well, I could either buy it straight from the Bank of Hagenstadt, which is probably what I'm going to end up doing. Yeah, because this is the car wash. But we don't have any tractors or any cars actually get dirty, so not that helpful on this map. Oh well. We'll see how this works. Alright. Turn this off. Yes. Yeah, this seems a little... This makes me a little sad. I don't know what it is now. To go back and look through the mods and see what mods I have that are randomly doing this, because I don't think we harvested after I installed a couple mods, so I'll have to go back and delete those mods. Because I don't think we ever actually got this much. Like 20,000 liters of canola already. Yeah, that's a little overkill. It must be from, I think the mod it might be from actually is the mod, what is it called? One of the maps I installed basically. And I think that's the one that caused this, at least, because this is a crazy amount of canola. So, like 20,000 liters and we're done like four passes. Normally it gets like halfway down the field, well, halfway down the field, but maybe a third of the way down the field and then it needs to unload, but maybe it was really good manure, right? Maybe we just chose the right combination of things this time around and that's the reason why we're getting so much. Let's just assume it was that, right? Oh man, that's what happens, I guess, when you test a lot of mods out and you try a few mods every now and then. You see what works and what doesn't work, and sometimes things do work but they cause other effects, and this appears to be one of them, because we're not necessarily driving really fast, but I guess we're driving fast enough to make this fill up way faster than it could be unloaded. Yeah, that's ridiculous. Oh well. Call it good fertilizer. That's what we will call it. If you haven't noticed, we're over 200,000 now. So the field we're looking at is 39. I'm not 28. While it's not too far, it's not too close either. And 186 isn't that much of a deal, basically. So what we'll probably do is we'll just go for the 200 and we could do field 40. Field 40 is a little far away. So what we'll do is we'll do field 39 and we'll buy that one probably. But we need to wait still for the money to come in, basically. So that's going to take a little bit of time before we can actually do that, unfortunately. So, and we do have to pay back our loan, so we probably will have to do that at some point as well. But we'll do that after we buy another field. Because one of the initial goals, if you guys remember, was to try and only survive on animals. And we've done that so far, with a little bit of help from the silage, at least. Which has been nice. The silage has kind of gave us a little bit, has given us a little bit of a push in the right direction, I guess. Basically because our cows, now they're making a good amount of money. So like that's probably from the cows. So 10,000 a day is not too bad for cows in reality. But if we want to, you know, progress a little bit further, then we'll have to think about that as well. So, and by progress a little bit further, I mean like maybe another field, maybe try out some corn, because we do have a corn field right there. Unfortunately, that particular field is crazy expensive. I think it's like $500,000. Yeah, $500,000 for that field, which is nuts. But if we go take a quick little jaunt over there, it's actually a pretty big field. So if you look at that, it's worth it, I guess. So it goes all the way down to the end down there, and it comes up all the way over here. There's our Kenworth taking another load of pigs to the market. So anyways, this is how big this field. It comes up all over here and actually goes a little bit further past our field, past our farm over here. So it goes further in here. I wonder if you can drive through these or not. I wonder, because these ones go right through the field here. So I think you can. And it actually goes all the way up here as well. And it's funny because this actually happens in real life. You actually do have some farms with telephone poles right in the middle of them. Of course, in real life, you can't drive through the poles, but in this game, you definitely can. So it goes all the way up to here. So it's quite a large field, as you can see. So it makes sense the reason why it's $500,000, but that's a crazy amount of money still. So yeah, that's all the same field. So quite a bit of property there that we could potentially get. But we're looking at field 39. Which is this one over here. So it's actually just a long, skinny field, but it's, you know, a bit longer actually than the field we have here. So, just to give you an idea. We're going to be able to buy this in a moment, so I'm just waiting for that actually, because our Kenworth is right at the farm. Well, not the farm. He's on the way to the market right now, and he's going to sell our pigs in a moment. And what I'll do is I'm going to cut this episode a little bit short, because that's going to bother me how much canola they're getting there. So we'll see what happens there. I'll have to go through and take out a couple mods, I think, because that is a little ridiculous. Yeah. And it's going to bug me until I figure out what it is as well. So 32,000 liters, yeah. So normally we don't even get, that's how much we get after the whole harvest, not just after a little tiny bit there. So whatever. We'll deal with it. All right, so field 39, what do we got? We can buy field 39. What else? Actually, you can get more than field 39. Field 40 is 200. That's field 4 is back in here. It's too far away, though. Field 42 is 1.4 million. Not happening. Field 33 is 330. We could get that field eventually, too, because that's a nice square field. Other ones could we get? We could get 28, but I don't like the way it, I don't like where it is. It's a little out of my way. Field 33 would be nice, and maybe field 42 or 41 would be nice as well. How much is 41? 41, 600. Yeah, that's not happening. So let's just go with that original intention, which was field 39, like so. So we're gonna go ahead and buy that. And weird. So 39 we can sell for 200,000, but field 38 can only sell for 84, but I bet you it's worth way more than that. Just a guess though. So, interesting. Oh well. So we're gonna go ahead and, well, I guess we could, we'll just wait till, what can we do? This guy's almost done. This guy's just sitting here. Let's use this guy. Let me get out of the tractor here. Let me unhook the PTO. Unhook that. Let's start the engine up. That always helps. And what I'll do is I'll just make the outline of the course, because I want to do that. So then I can just set up everything else. Because basically I could use the same course for everything else. Because it's so close, it'll just basically go to the nearest position, which will be nice. And now, actually, I could bring these two fields together and make it one big field, but I think I'll keep it separate for the time being, because I want to plant, or be able to plant two different things. All right, so let's do a little outline of the course here. or outline of the field. I need to be careful because this tractor does move at a pretty quick pace, and I want to be able to turn nicely. And actually, I think it actually tips over if you're not careful as well, so. Just gotta slow down when I get to the end, is what it boils down to. Alright, slow, slow, slow. Turn. You can actually do this with field markers and pause the course at the end, but I don't know. I've had problems with those, so I'm just gonna do it this way, because this way has worked well for me so far, so. And if my outline's wrong, I can always go back and change it, but usually the difference is minimal when you actually do this. It might be like a little smidgen of land, but for the most part, you'll get most of it, so. Alright, let's turn this off here, like so. And stop right there. Perfect. So this is F39 outline. Alright, I'm actually going to stop the episode there because, like I said, that's going to annoy me why that is, because that should not be the case at this point. So I'm going to stop the episode there for now, folks. Bit of a shorter one today, but I did a long one just before this, so that's probably why I feel like I need to keep it a bit shorter, but also because of that weird bug we seem to be having at the moment. Alright, so my name is Ian Robson. This has been Farming Simulator 2013, and we're playing on the Bayern Farm. Catch you guys later.